And how do we obey Allah? To follow His book, to follow the Quran. And how do we obey a Rasul? To follow Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And as we know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-Baqarah, شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ هُدًى لِلنَّاسِ وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِّنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ. The month of Ramadan is the one month where the Quran was revealed. Hudan linnas, guidance. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us the Quran is guidance for all of us. وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِّنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ. And the clear right thing, obvious to everybody. And yet how many of us, when we're asked about our constitution, we say our constitution is the Quran. We want to write our own constitution, man-written constitutions, rather than go and say that our constitution is the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives all the things that we would want and more in the Quran. Tells us about equality, tells us about freedom, tells us about everything nice that we would like to have. Why do we need to write our own constitution when we have the Quran clear? Hudan linnas, guidance. How many of us, when we hear this, we say we want to follow this guidance? As it says in the first ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. This book, there is no doubt about it, guidance. Guidance for those who observe Allah. And why? Because if we notice the two ayahs before it, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all our prayers, guide us to the straight path. And the answer comes, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. This book is the guidance. So we ask for guidance, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the guidance in the Quran. So why don't we follow the Quran? Why don't, when we read it, we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to us, is talking to each and every one of us, subhanallah. This is what the beauty of the Quran is. It is Allah talking to us. And as we read the Quran during the months of Ramadan, or we listen to the Quran, listen and reflect on the meaning, who is the author, who's talking, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking. It's not, most of us will say, let's find the sheikh with a nice voice that he recites nicely. As if we're listening to a song and we do not reflect on the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He's telling us, do and do not do, and He gives us example. And the part I really resent a lot, when we read about the stories of Bani Israel, and people start putting them down. And I tell them, Bani Israel, some of them were good. Most of the prophets, other than Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is from Bani Israel. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give us the Quran to put Bani Israel down. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the Quran to learn how other people were guided by Allah and what happened when they got misguided. So we take the lessons. We learn our lessons for them, not to say, look at them. Because as the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, we will follow the footsteps of the people before us, step by step. And even if they go in a cage of a wild animal, we'll go behind after them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us the stories of the people before us. To tell us how some people could have the great book among them, and they don't follow, and look what they follow. And it is the best way to teach. Rather than tell you, if you don't, this will happen to you, give us an example of what others, how, and what their footsteps happened, and what happened to them because they didn't follow. Subhanallah, so we learn that the Quran is talking to us. Every story is for us to learn and take the examples and apply to our life, not to make mockery of somebody else. Subhanallah, when we hear the ayat of punishment, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from this, to save us from the misguidance they might have fell in, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us that we are on the straight path.